Good morning and welcome to Arrow FM. You're listening to RAM, Random Access Memory, where I tell you what is going on around the wonderful Wairarapa for the next week. So there's quite a lot going on this week, especially today, which is good for a Thursday. I'm having lots of things for everyone to sink their teeth into. So starting off, there is a Wairarapa foster care information evening tonight, held at the Lighthouse Church. So all the information is on Facebook. It's 23 Intermediate Street is where the Lighthouse Church is in Masterton. And it just says come and find out more about foster care and how you can become a foster parent. So there is an RSVP, but yeah, all the information is on their Facebook. So just look up Wairarapa foster care information evening on there and you can find out all the information on how to register to go to this really exciting event. And then there is also the community engagement made easy with Be Collective evening tonight. So it's at the 3 Mile co-working community place, 66 High Street North. So it is at 5:30 till 7. So it just says, we know there's a lot of hard workers out there volunteering, leading creative change and being awesome. We also know there's a lot of challenges in the community for engagement space. Finding, managing, rewarding and retaining volunteers is a biggie. So join them for this workshop, which will work with helping you think about your processes and how you can enhance others, as well as help you with ideas on how to develop and contribute to your volunteer pathways to employment and grow your ecosystem of support. So it's quite a cool one. So if you don't know about the co-working place, it's really cool how you can go and you can work and just be surrounded by other people who are, you know, maybe working from home, but now they've now got a space to do it and just be able to chat to each other and really just vibe off each other and continue to grow. So Be Collective is an interactive workshop for anyone involved in community projects. It was created to support and empower New Zealanders to contribute to their communities by doing what they can when they can. So it's a really awesome thing that is happening tonight. So it's free for 3 Mile members, or it's koha for everyone else, and there will be wine and nibbles for people to enjoy. So that is at the 3 Mile co-working community centre, 63 High Street North, and it's running from 5:30 to 7 tonight, which is Thursday night. Also tonight there is the Air Force on tour. This is quite cool. So the Royal New Zealand Air Force Band will be on our road entertaining the masses. So it's at the Carton Event Centre tonight at 7 o'clock. So tickets are available on Event Finder. So the Air Force Band is renowned for its eclectic, stunning performances. So it's the tour is going all around the country and taking audiences on a wild ride of musical styles, from military classics to popular show tunes. So there's some amazing songs that we'll be playing and talent that will be on display at the the Carton Event Centre tonight. So there are still tickets available. So go onto Event Finder and snap yourself a ticket to see some amazing performances tonight by the Royal New Zealand Air Force Band. And there is another thing on tonight. See, it's very busy tonight. Thursday night, for some reason, everyone's enjoying wanting to start their weekend early and having events on Thursday night. So there is also another event, an evening with Sophie Cunningham, author of City Trees. So it is at the Royal Hotel, 22 Reven Street in Featherston. It's starting at 7:30 p.m. So it's she's the author and she's going to come and talk. It's associated with the New Zealand a Festival of Arts Writers program. So it's she wrote about an essay of life and death and the need for a forest in conversation with author Vivian Plum. So how do any of us, humans, animals, trees, find a forest we can call home? City of Trees is a powerful collection of nature, travel and memoir writing set in the context of global climate change. It meanders through cycles around and sometimes faces head on the most pressing issues of the day and never loses sight of the city of trees. So she's going to come and she's going to talk to everyone over there about her processes and everything like that. It'll be really interesting to talk to an author. It's a very much loved book, so if you haven't read it, go check it out. So tonight at the Royal Hotel in Featherston at 7:30, an evening with Sophie Cunningham, the author of The City of Trees. So that is Thursday. So since there's so much happening on Thursday, I thought we'd just start off with some music already before we get on to Friday and the rest of the week. So this is the Lumineers' Ophelia.
When I was young, should have known better, and I can't feel no remorse, and you don't feel nothing bad. I got a new girl.
So that was Ophelia from the Lumineers. So even more happening, not just on Thursday. So on Friday, there is Colombo No Menu Night. So this is held at the Colombo in Martinborough, which is 107 Todd's Road. So this month they are excited to welcome back an Australian chef to come and put on this amazing dinner. So it is on Friday. Drinks start at 5:30 and dinner is served at 6 p.m. So it's $20 per plate. There are vegetarian and gluten-free options available. And also the Colombo wines and local beers. There will be live music from Warwick Murray. It's a non-booking event, so just head along and find a spot. And they look forward to seeing you there. So they run this, I believe it's monthly, where you can just rock up and just enjoy a lovely meal. And $20 is a pretty good price to get an amazing meal for the day. So that is at at Colombo, Martinborough, 107 Todd's Road, starting at 5:30 for drinks, and food is at 6 o'clock, so it's $20 per person. And then we are on to Saturday. So Saturday, Marston District Library, they're presenting a Children's Day. So it's from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. At the library of 54 Queen Street in Masterton. So it says, come out to the library on Saturday to celebrate the children of New Zealand. They'll be hosting Jonas, who will lead the children in an interactive workshop with hundreds of musical instruments. Everyone will play along while singing and drumming together. So there will be a little bit of snacks as well. There is no registration required, so it's just about getting kids out, enjoying music and having a bit of a jam. So that is on Saturday from 10 to 11 at the Marston District Library. So there's some pretty interesting things going on this weekend. And this one isn't in Wairarapa, but it is for Wairarapa people. So it's the Wellington Wairarapa Regional Excavator Operator Competition. It's at Trentham Memorial Park from 8:30, pretty much all day till 5:30. So this is on Saturday. So it's the Wellington and Wairarapa region's finest excavator operators will battle it out at the CCNZ Wellington Wairarapa Branch Cable Price Regional Excavator Operator Competition. It's a bit of a mouthful. So it's held during the Upper Hutt Summer Carnival on Saturday. So there are entries are open. The Crown Champion will have the chance to battle it out against the regional finalists from other branches throughout the country at the annual CCNZ Cable Price National Excavator Operator Competition held at the Central District's Field Day in Fielding in March. So it's quite cool and quite different. So there's so many things for everyone around here. So that is at Trentham Memorial Park on Saturday between 8:30 and 5:30. Also on Saturday there is astro imaging course at Stonehenge. It's really cool how we've got this dark sky coming along and just taking advantage of it. It's amazing. I don't know about anyone else, but I absolutely love just going outside and looking at the stars and just having a break. You can just stare at them forever. I wish I knew all about them. Those people who know all about the different constellations just amaze me. But on Saturday from 12:30 to 5:30 at Stonehenge, there is an astro imaging course. So if you've ever wanted to take images of the night sky but are not sure what camera you need or what sort of setting you should be on or how to compose your shot, it's the course for you. So the fees are $59 for adults, $48 for seniors and school students, $30. So booking is essential, so call 06-377-1600. So this is, it's quite cool, so if you've ever wanted to take photos but just not quite sure, head along to this course at Stonehenge on Saturday, 12:30 to 5:30, and just call 06-377-1600 to book your place. So that is everything for Saturday. I have another song which I will play for you all right now. This is Jeremy Zucker, Always I'll Care. Or maybe it won't be. It does not want to play. No worries, we will try something else. So I'll just go on to Sundays and, oh wait, no. Yeah, no, it doesn't want to play. That's fine. So I will just go on to what is happening on Sunday and we'll see if we can get this to start working. Oh, here we go. It is playing. Here we go. Jeremy Zucker, Always I'll Care.
Driving down the interstate, I've never felt so far away. Leaving hardly hurts at all. I'm sorry that I never called. Oh.
often I get exhausted, trying regardless to be enough. Is it selfish not to be selfless when all I can help is to open up? I'll be better than I was before, despite every text of yours ignored. Will you call me still just to hear my voice? I swear, always I'll care. Flipping through our photographs, those moments never seem to last. Listening to self-control, those feelings that you'll never know. Leave me, it's never easy. I've had a lifetime to be alone. If you let me, when it gets heavy, no, I'll never let you be all alone. I'll be better than I was before, despite every text of yours ignored. Will you call me still just to hear my voice? I swear, always. Always, I'll care. Always.
Okay, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed that music. We finally got it working, which is good. Always get a bit of technical trouble, but that's fine. So we have a guest here. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hello. And I do a lot of music things in Wairarapa.
Mm-hmm.
Started probably 4 years ago or something like that, after coming from Europe, where I was becoming quite a well-known musician. So it was a nice, humbling process to come to Wairarapa and being not known mm-hmm. musician and being the delivery driver and things like that. And now we do... a lot of musical stuff now, actually. I'm booked for a long time to the future, and so there are a few events that I would like to invite people.
Mm-hmm.
And
would you be able to speak a little bit closer?
Yep. So one of them is the regular every Tuesday music. I don't really know how to call it, but it's just sort of like how we call it? Wairarapa music co-creation meetups.
Yeah, just about getting everyone to together and to give it a go and get their creative juices flowing in a way.
Yeah, exactly. And it's exciting that it's, we did it for quite a long time in Aratoi Museum in Masterton. Mm-hmm. So it was twice supported by the Masterton creative communities. And then when I got a clear message that I can't really apply for any funding here, then I started to do it in Carterton. And again, quite a unique thing happened that they actually supported us twice in a row. So we still have this during this school term. We just do it really every Tuesday in the evening, and all ages are welcome. No one have to know anything. We just have really a huge pile of musical instruments, and we just have fun with that and play.
Mm-hmm. No, that's awesome. So what time is it?
6:30 p.m. starting.
6:30. No, that's awesome. It's always good to have these events where people can kind of just go and dip their toe in and see if they have a little musical bone in their body, but even if they don't, just have a bit of fun.
Well, I think we all do. It's just really about having some encouragement to
mm-hmm.
to really not have the fear and just try it.
Mm-hmm. Have you found any hidden talented musicians in the Wairarapa since running these groups?
Everyone.
Everyone?
Yeah, well, I have a trick because I have really great instruments which are tuned the way that people cannot do a mistake. So it's tuned for people who, how to say that? Well, just one finger is all mm-hmm. you need to strum or play the drum, or, you know, and it's tuned the way that anyone does a great job without even possibility to play a mistakes.
Oh, that's awesome. Definitely builds up the confidence of people giving it a go then.
It looks like.
That's awesome. So you're going to be running the event at the district library this Saturday, but you said there was also other events that you do as well.
Yeah, there are many events. Like people usually know me on the street doing the drumming circles and all kinds of public performances as the one which will be in the library. We will quite possibly be outside. Mm-hmm. Not sure yet, depends on the weather. But yeah, it's a children's day, so this Saturday, I think it's 10 o'clock, yeah. We'll be doing a lot of noises there and a lot of fun, hopefully singing. Hopefully all ages will be part of it. At least my 14-month-old son will be there, mm-hmm. jamming with us. And then the same or similar event will be happening as well in the library on 24th of March. And yeah.
Just about getting everyone out and playing some music and having a bit of fun. And
yeah, exactly. It's really a great community thing to just come together. And we are so lucky that, I'm originally from Czech Republic, and mm-hmm. I just really didn't experience many times to be able to provide such a experience for people for free or for koha. Mm-hmm. So I feel that we are very blessed that we have this opportunity to just come and be part of something like that without wondering how much it is, or you don't have to register, you don't have to do anything, just come and jump into the pile of the instruments.
Yeah, it's all about getting the community together and having a go and taking the restrictions away.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's awesome. It's cool to see those sorts of things happening in the Wairarapa. I think it makes it special when there is so many events that are just koha or so cheap.
Yeah.
So it takes that barrier away so everyone can go have some fun, mm-hmm. and dip their toe in something different and try some music. So what's your favourite instrument to see people pick up and have a go at? Or what's the most popular one?
I just really think that drums.
Drums?
Because I have I don't know, because they are slowly disappearing. I'm selling them. People who are interested in the African drums, the djembe. So I think I have now maybe 50 drums. And that's usually, especially in the schools or in the kindergartens, mm-hmm. or anywhere I do something with kids, that's the main focus, I think. I can see that they are interested. They like to see such exotic instruments as a sitar or, mm-hmm. Unusual things. But drum is just really easy to understand. You just beat it and it just makes a sound.
Makes noise. No, that's awesome. So is there any way people can get in contact with you if they want to book an event or have mm-hmm. you come along?
Yeah, I have a website which is connecting-music.nz, and that's where most of the workshops are scheduled and where my contact details are.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot of fun, and I'm really happy to get new advices or new challenges from mm-hmm. the community to be invited to other places. We also did a great thing with the intergenerational groups. I don't know if you heard about it, but it's still happening, not as regular as before, where we actually bring the children to the rest homes and do the music all together for 1 hour of singing and drumming and jamming. And
that's awesome.
It's just, those are really very touching moments when you see big drum with the skin on the top, mm-hmm. and you just see 90 old years hand next to the 2 or 3 years old mm-hmm. hand playing together the same rhythm. And it's a really, music is amazing tool for us to relate to each other, to connect.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what we do.
Yeah, well, I used to be part of this group that used to go around and sing at rest homes, and it was amazing just seeing them because they'd always join in.
Mm-hmm.
So having the instruments for them to encourage them to join in, I'm sure they would be up and rearing to make some noise as well, and watching younger kids being happy as well. There's nothing that puts your smile on your face like watching a 4-year-old or something just have a massive smile and have fun. So sounds like an awesome thing to do.
And people would be surprised how wild it can get in their homes. Like,
yeah.
Even the dance sometimes.
Yeah. That's awesome. So how do you come up with the ideas of what's going to happen at all these events?
Oh, it's just I do it for decades, and you know, I'm trained music therapist and music teacher, and I just did so many. I just do it almost every day, so there is every day there is a new inspiration, and it just comes in the middle of the program. You know, I don't want it to be boring for myself or for people who are coming again and again, so it always. Something happens in my mind and I was like, why don't we do this? Why didn't we do it always? This so we just do some new dance or some new song, some new interaction. It's mainly a lot of fun, but if we work with adults only, it may also turn quite into the meditation or into really calming time. Which reminds me, one more event that we will do in the combination with the dance leader, we will do, it's coming up soon, it's I think Sunday 8th, so next Sunday in Carterton School Hall, we will have a teacher from Wellington who is really great in encouraging people to dance in the free movement, and she usually uses the speakers, but this time she will use myself instead of the speakers, so I'll be there doing the music in the to be probably mainly quite a relaxation that we will be dancing, but not only, we'll be also playing and singing all together, and really anyone can join in. Doesn't matter if you have a professional voice or not voice at all, you just can jump into the group, and so that promises not just fun, but I think also quite a little bit deeper dive into the inner landscapes.
That's awesome. Those sorts of, like, seeing there's so many different events that can be run with music, and it's always encouraging when people just kind of get behind it. Like, I don't know if this happens, but you know, at the start everyone's a bit quiet and not too sure, but towards the end there's not one person who wouldn't be passionate about what they're doing and having a great time.
Yep, that's true. I had one group in Czech Republic in the middle of some village. They just booked me, so I came in. When I told them, they were mainly grandmothers, just a bunch of grandmothers sitting on the drums, and I was telling them, okay, so now I want to do some like improvisational music with you, I want you to sing, and they were like, no, I'm leaving. They just didn't want to be part of that. But when they tried, after a few minutes I wanted to stop it. We all had closed eyes, and it was impossible to stop. So I opened my eyes and saw those grandmothers jumping on the drums and drumming and singing like, you know, First Nations from Canada, and it was totally wild. It was, it's dynamics. You're right.
It has a way of bringing out the excitement and a kid of everyone in a way sometimes. And that's awesome. Well, thanks for coming in and chatting to me and telling everyone about the different events. So make sure you go online. Do you want to say your website again so people know where to find all the info?
It's connecting-music.nz.
Awesome. So go on there, and remember there is the event every Tuesday.
Yes, every Tuesday during the school term.
So look for all the information. That event is also usually on Facebook as well, which you can look up. It's occasionally put on there, so you can see the times and place. But it is just Koha for everyone.
Yes, and it's at Heart of Arts, which is just on the High Street, little gallery. And I just had a thought about one non-musical event. Can I say that as well? So we started a men's group, which is just open to anyone, any man in Wairarapa. Or doesn't even have to be from Wairarapa. We have some Australians there as well, or Czechs. And it's happening every first Thursday of the month at the Carterton Courthouse, the community courthouse next to the event center. It starts at 7 p.m. and goes for 2 hours. And it's really just for sharing and encouraging the mutual support in the neighborhood.
Mm-hmm. Breaking down barriers.
Yeah, there is some people are quite fragile when they come in, mm-hmm. and they don't want to share, so it's all right. We can just sit in the corner and just observe. Some people are the other way around. They are quite intense and they just want to let it all out. So mm-hmm. it's an interesting mixture of different characters. And again, all ages, from teenagers till mm-hmm. people who are in their 80s. And what we also do is that every third Saturday we do the same, but overnight in the mountains by the campfire, which is even more magical because it's mm-hmm. really just on the riverbank and there is more time to share the stories and learn from each other.
Just a safe, open space for men to talk.
Yeah, and cook listen. Together.
And cook. Maybe learn some new recipes.
Oh, yeah, there are some very interesting inventions happening.
Yeah. Oh, it'll be interesting. You never know what you're going to get at the end of the night then. No, that's awesome. Well, thanks for coming in and chatting to me. And, yeah, I can't wait to hear all the music that keeps coming out of these events. And hopefully if anyone else wants to book an event, just go onto the website and you can find all the contact information there. So thank you for coming in. So I'll put on some music. So this is Million Ways.
Sunday morning, I woke up with no one beside me. Reaching out for you like you were still there. Gave excuses like no labels, I'm not ready. Now I'm drowning in a sea of regret, yeah. I'm not gonna say goodbye, cause I'm gonna change your mind. Let me love you all day. I got a million ways. I'm not gonna give you up. I got you, I swear to God. Let me love you all day. I got a million ways. When I'm out late thinking of ya, I'ma call ya, yeah. To show you I care, but no one compares. When we get older, I wanna be there. Swim a mountain, climb an ocean, do it for ya. No, I'm not gonna say goodbye, oh, no. Cause I'm gonna change your mind. Let me love you all day. I got a million ways. I'm not gonna give you up. I got you, I swear to God. Let me love you all day. Got a million ways.
That was Million Ways by HRVY. So I hope you enjoyed that. And I hope you have found an event you want to go to. It's really good having all these different things where you can go dip your toe in, try some music, just have some fun. And it's always good to get your inspirations going, especially, you know, if you haven't, if you want to just have a break and get your mind off things, music is amazing. So now we are on to what is happening on Sunday. So there's quite a cool event happening in Wellington, but it is definitely for something that means a lot to the Wairarapa as well. It's for Lifelight. So there's the Lifelight Open Day happening down at their bays on 17 George Bolt Street in Wellington. So it is right on by the airport, on the opposite side than the Wellington airport, and right next to, right on the tarmac. And it's just a great day to go see what they do. There's obviously fundraisers. All the money goes towards Lifelight, helping them continue to save lives. So it's running from 10 a.m. till 2:30 on Sunday. So Lifelight, they pretty much serve, they come to the Wairarapa nearly every single day, probably. They have their two fixed wing planes and the helicopter. So if you ever needed one of those services, you'll realise how important it is and how lucky we are to have it in our region. Especially rural and coastal, the ability for the helicopter to get pretty much nearly anywhere in the Wairarapa within about 20 minutes, it saves lives, and it's all from donations and people helping and everything like that. So it's amazing what they do. So on Sunday, starting at 10 till 2:30, down at Lifelight, you can go down. There's going to be over a dozen emergency services there, from obviously Lifelight, aviation security, customer detective dogs, fire and emergency, land and rescue, police, New Zealand Air Force, and so many more. So there's heaps of different emergency services that will be down there. So you're not only going to learn about Lifelight, you're going to learn about so many others. And there's also going to be obviously entertainment for everyone, live music, kids zone, costume contest, obstacle races, mini jeeps, paper plane throwing contest, spot prizes, so many things for people to do, food, beverages, obviously, like always, so you're not going to have, not going to get hungry. And there is going to be demonstrations. So there's going to be demonstrations for so many different things. It's going to start off with a customs detector dog demo at 10:45, and then there'll be winch, the chopper winch rescue demo, airport fire service demo, and then there's going to be the costume contest and so many other things. So there's not only going to be things to do, things to see, things to eat, but also different experiences to see, and to see how these different emergency services help and service all around New Zealand and especially our Wairarapa. So it is open for everyone. It's just, I believe it is koha entry for the day. And it's on Sunday, down in Wellington, 17 George Bolt Street, and it runs from 10 to 2:30. So if you do have the day, or if you're in Wellington, go support Lifelight, go see what they do. They're amazing, and the dedication and everything they do for not only the Wairarapa, but the whole of New Zealand is amazing. So that is on this Sunday, their open day. So there is also the Tikaranga Farmers Market at 89 Martins Road in Martinborough. So it's on Sunday from 10 till 4. So their monthly market is on. There'll be live music from Loose Jandal playing all day while you wander around the lawn, shopping from local producers, grabbing a bite to eat, a glass of wine, enjoying a little pocket of Martinborough. So the market hours are from 10 till 2. And the cellar doors are open from 10 till 4, and live music will be from 10 till 3. So I hope if you're down in South Wairarapa, go head along to the market on Sunday. If you are further up north, there is the Paihia Tour Sharing 2020 competition. It's all day, starting at 8, at the Empire Tour, and it's just an action-packed day. All the information is on Facebook. There's not that much information, so literally all I have is that it's on. But the sharing day is on Sunday, starting at 8 o'clock. And then also getting people out again. More about getting people out. seeing the community. If you've ever wondered where your food comes from, ever wondered how farms go and everything like that, there is actually open days this Sunday at three different farms around the region. So you can meet some animals, explore the bush, the streams, try your hand at planting, harvesting, see some shearing demos, a whole lot of different things that'll be going on. So you just have to go to openfarms.co.nz/events. You do have to register so the farms know you're going, but they're pretty much open around 10 a.m. till 4. So there's ones out to the east, a little bit north, and all the way in South Wairarapa, Palliser Ridge. So it is a family-friendly afternoon. You can learn a whole lot of different things. Each one has different events happening, but it's a great time. Like, what a perfect picnic, going out, learning, connecting to nature, connecting to the lands, learning so much about farms, and just having a lovely picnic in amazing scene and just taking a break. So that is on Sunday. So if you do want to know more or feel like booking in and going looking at one of these farms, go to openfarms.co.nz/event and have a look, see which one's close. If you want to go for a drive, there's ones all over that are open, not just in the Wairarapa. So hopefully everyone can find something that they would be interested in. So that is everything that is on this weekend and this week. There's quite a lot going on, which is exciting. So now I'm going to play some music. If it doesn't, we're just going to keep going because we actually don't have that much time left. We've had amazing guests come in today and have a chat, which is great. So this is Paloma Faith, Just Be. It's acoustic version, and then we will get back onto what is on all next week in the Wairarapa.
Let's get old together. Let's be unhappy forever. 'Cause there's no one else in this world that I'd rather be unhappy with. Let's be exposed and unprotected. Let's see one another when we're weak. Let's go our separate ways in the night like two moths, but know that you're flying home to me. I was born thinking it would all be dreaming. Let us unfold one another and watch all the little things that once drew me to you eventually get on my nerves. I weigh well with frustration and heartache and anger, but we wait. Nothing, just sit next just be, oh.
Was Paloma Faith Just Be. I hope you enjoyed. So now we're just going to get on to the last things that are happening starting next week. So there's still lots going on. There's a lot going on in the Wairarapa, which is awesome, getting this year really into motion. So there is the Featherston Senior Citizens Club Cards happening on Monday. It's 1 o'clock. And so it's on each Monday, 1 o'clock till 4, at the Featherston Community Centre, 14 Wakefield Street. So they share a room with Mahjong players in the front of the cozy, Woodburner. So come play social card games, make new friends, catch up with old ones. The club cards meets at each week. It is koha of $2 per participant. It's just about chatting, catching up with people, getting out and about. So that is on Mondays at 1 o'clock till 4. So you can come the whole time for a little bit, whatever you need. Featherston Senior Citizens Club Cards on Mondays, 14 Wakefield Street. And on Tuesdays is the Wairarapa Music Co-Creation Meetup. So this is what we were talking about before. So it is at 6:30 every Tuesday during the school term at Heart of Arts. So you heard us talk about how amazing it is to get everyone out playing music, having a go. You can't do a wrong note. You can't make a wrong sound. It's all about just giving it a go, getting out. So that is on Tuesdays at the Heart of Arts. And then on Wednesday is NZSO Setting Up Camp Goldberg Variations. So it's at the Cardston Event Centre. Tickets are available on Eventfinder. And it's just NZSO coming for an amazing performance once again. So it is on Wednesday, 7:30. A whole lot of different musicians coming. They travel throughout New Zealand all the time. So if you've caught NZSO before, you know the talent and the quality of the music that they play. If you haven't, then definitely head along to this one. It is on Wednesday and all the information and tickets are available on Event Finder. And then on this Monday is the last one of the kids, the Breadcraft Wairarapa Kids Triathlon Series. So it's been going for the last 2 weeks, last two Mondays. There's been around 470 kids every week. It's $10 to register. Registrations are available online, or you can register on the night, but you have to get there if you want to register early. Registrations will close at 5:20, so if you're not there before then, you won't be able to register. If you have registered and done the other two, then you just need to go to the pre-registration tent, get your name highlighted and your number on your arm, and you're good to go. This is the last one, and so those who have done all three, they go into a special draw for a different major prize. So we really do encourage all the kids to get out and have a go. It's from ages 3 to about 17. We have a few older kids, which is awesome to see, but there's so many young kids, and seeing them run and have a big smile when they come over is awesome, and seeing them get out and be active is really, really cool. So it's held on Monday. Registrations open at 4:15, and everyone needs to be registered by 5:20 before there is the briefing at 5:30, and they start as soon as they can straight after. So it's at the Wairarapa College grounds. So if you need any information, you can find it on their Facebook page, or you can call Judy Brown on 06378 7867. So if you haven't gone, definitely head to this one, and if you have, look forward to seeing you all there again. And the last thing we have on our list is obviously the big thing this year. The Golden Shears are back. So it is at the Marston War Memorial Stadium, 2 Dixon Street in Marston. It starts on Wednesday, 12:30. It's the world's premier shearing and wool handling championship. So 2020 marks the 60th anniversary of the Golden Shears. It's pretty awesome. It will be a four-day event encompassing novice, junior, intermediate, senior, and open shearing competition, along with junior, senior, and open wool handling events and wool pressing competitions, as well as the coveted triathlon award. So the special events for 2020 include blade shearing and evergreen shearing and wool handling. So there's going to be over 400 national and international competitors in Marston for the 4 days of competition. The major events and finals and live entertainment are held on Friday and Saturday night. So do not miss your chance. Tickets are available, and any information you need, go to goldenshears.co.nz. You'll find it all there, when the competition is, when everything is on, get your tickets, everything like that. So it is awesome. This is what we are known for. This is why we have Golden Shears out the front of Marston. So head along. There will be some locals there that you can cheer on. We've got some pretty good history with coming in this competition, doing really well. So Golden Shears starting Wednesday. Any information you need, go to goldenshears.co.nz, and it is on for the rest of the week. So that is everything that I have. I hope you guys have found something that you would like to go to this week and next week. And I look forward to talking to you next Thursday morning. I hope you all have an amazing week and enjoy the sun. Thank you to our sponsor, Trust House, for helping us run this event. Run this program, and I look forward to hearing you all next week. Goodbye.